It's Madden NFL 22 on EA Sports. And tonight's Clash of Conferences is just moments away. It's the Niners and the Titans on EA Sports.
All in all, we have a pretty pleasant December day in the Volunteer State. The chilly rain from last night has moved on. The temps have bumped up a bit here at Nissan Stadium in Nashville. The whole of downtown Nashville likely still reverberating with the sounds of the Titans taking the field a moment ago. They're ready for football as their Titans are set to match up with the San Francisco 49ers.
Brandon Gordon alongside the one and only Charles Davis. And CD, lots of compelling storylines in a game like this. Let's take a look at some of the numbers for these two offenses.
And I'm glad you brought up the numbers, because sometimes it's hard to quantify a team's performance solely by judging the numbers. But I think with these two teams, what you see is a pretty accurate representation of who they are.
The veteran kicker, Robbie Gould, set to get us started. And off we go from Nashville. Ready to return, here's Hilliard.
And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. Now come the Titans for their first possession, led by Ryan Tannehill in his 10th NFL season and third with Tennessee.
And one of the things that has really impressed me about Ryan Tannehill has been his perseverance. Early in his career, didn't have the success that he desired. Had some injuries that slowed his development, but he kept working at his craft, and now he's a guy that I think you can put a game on his shoulders.
On first and 10, Tannehill. Got his man, that's the Pro Bowler, Julio Jones. What you got? And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
A good gain on first has him set up with second and just a couple of inches now from the 29.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield, because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
They'll fake it. Now Tannehill. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Now Tannehill. That's complete to his tight end, Firkser. That'll leave him with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
Let's not quibble about the game there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
And he'll give it here to his running back. Oh, they hit him in the backfield, and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
Oftentimes, when you see a running back get bunched up in the backfield, it's usually because the defensive tackle is eating up blockers for others to make the play. Not in this case.
On fourth down, here's Brett Kern to punt the football away. Yeah, he was looking for the checkup bounce, didn't get it. That scoots all the way into the end zone now for a touchback. The 49er offense coming out here for the first time, led by their quarterback, Jimmy Garoppolo. Garoppolo, fifth season with the 49ers, eighth overall in the National Football League.
And Jimmy Garoppolo has shown that he can be a Super Bowl quarterback, but his biggest problem, his ability to stay healthy and remain on the field. When able, he's a capable quarterback prone to winning games both in the regular and postseason.
Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. And he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of two, and it brings up second down.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
From the 22, here's second and eight. Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he'll get about six up to the 27-yard line.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Here we go. On third down, Mitchell. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage.
Well, partner, none of these runs individually have added up to a whole lot.
Now, three plays, all three short runs, but together a first down.
Yeah, it's amazing how the narrative changes when you string them together.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll try the left side. It's Mitchell, and he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, second down.
I know we can't hear what's going on in that huddle right now, but I'll guarantee you at least one offensive lineman is saying, my bad, we simply couldn't move him off the line of scrimmage. We've got to do a better job trying to root those guys out of there.
Second and eight coming up. Now they'll throw with Garoppolo. That's to Mitchell out of the backfield. They'll wind up getting seven on the play, and that'll make it third and one. Hands it off out of the gun. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down. Yes, it's the first half, but we'll see if that stuff there on third and one comes back to haunt him.
I hope you don't mind, but it's not going to stop me from putting a check mark next to this play. Let's look back as this game progresses and see if this is one of the key plays in the game, even though it occurred early.
So on fourth down, here's the Australian native Mitch Wisnowski to punt this one away. Back deep, Chester Rogers. Yeah. It's a 42-yard punt. They keep him to just a yard on the return. And the Titans will be backed up deep to begin the drive as they take over first and 10. The Titans coming back onto the field for their second drive. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
They'll start on the ground with McNichols. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. He'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness, he's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a 2nd and 11. Out of the gun, Tannehill. And he goes down. It's a sack. They get him back at his own 3-yard line. And Nick Bosa so quick on the outside. He gets in there to bring him down.
I think most quarterbacks would love to have the goal line actually extend up into the air and turn into a wall. They could put their back against it and know exactly where they are on the field so they don't end up in the end zone. Didn't do it on that play, but perilously close to the goal line.
After the sack, they'll come up now 3rd and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
And indeed, that's what they'll do as they run it here. And he's able to get this one up to the 8-yard line this time. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it'll bring up a 4th down. Well, they did go run, so you were right. Maybe a little more breathing room for 4th down.
Well, no one wants to be accused of playing it safe, right? But instead, they would just reverse it and say, we're playing it smart.
Here's Brett Kern now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. This returnable for Ayuk. So holding there on the return, and that'll back him up to start the next drive.
Yeah, that's a pretty easy call right there, partner. I think when the officials look in their manual and see the expression, jersey getting pulled, that's a flag coming out every time.
The 49ers with the football here to begin the 2nd quarter as they get set to start their drive with a 1st and 10. They fake the give. Now Garoppolo looks to throw. And this one caught along the sideline, but they say already out of bounds. And the throw didn't give him a chance to turn it upfield, and that brings up 2nd down.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. Play action. Now Garoppolo. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45.
And partner, they're locked in man coverage out left, and they end up running a crossing route. Rounded it a little bit more than a slant. And he's just going to angle himself towards the right side of the field, and that's very difficult for a defender to shadow him across all that ground.
So the 14 yards actually takes him from 143 to the other for 1st and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. Bringing him down defensively, Jayon Brown.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5.
from the gun. He'll hand this off.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
All over you.
Those are the types of run, Charles, that they say this first-year running back can provide a lot more of in the future.
He made it look easy, didn't he? Picking up that first down. Some have described him as a diamond in the rough. With a lot of polish, nice little buffing, this guy could be one of the top backs going forward.
Garoppolo now, first down throw. And this complete to Mitchell. Call it a gain of 6 on the play, and that'll make it second down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
On second down now. It's Mitchell, and just a couple yards there down to the 17.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense, and guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time, but you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Garoppolo going to try and throw on third. That's complete to Dwelly, his tight end. And the Niners are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
And in a lot of ways, that catch is expected. Red zone presence, and that one was realized there. You've got to find your tight end in that situation.
Here we go now on first and goal. There's Garoppolo to throw. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
And I could see the officials kind of looking at each other down there, silently wondering, does this meet the level of grounding? Fortunately, he did have a receiver in the area, but I have seen less obvious throwaways called as penalties.
They'll go again here from the 10-yard line on second and goal. From the gun, it's Garoppolo. That is caught by the tight end, Kittle. Touchdown, 49ers. 10 yards on the touchdown pass as his guys are on the board first here tonight.
Well, the lost sleep that the defensive coordinator had all week preparing for this game, a good portion of it was trying to prepare for him because he's absolutely a phenomenal player.
And a lot of times around the goal line, they know it's going to him. It's just so hard to stop.
And that's where it really becomes difficult because you're exactly right. They know it's going to him, yet they still can't stop it. That tells you when you're a dominant player.
Gold with the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. That time, a 9-play drive, and it's polished off by a touchdown for San Francisco. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. And Hilliard will elect to not return
it. That's it, baby. We're going to work.
The Titans set and ready to go on offense. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now.
Winning!
Now it's Tannehill looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. Picked up by the all-pro corner, Josh Norman. And his guys will take over at the 25-yard line. When I looked down, he was kind of shaking his head right after he threw that pass. What did you see?
Well, from a defense's perspective, anytime you have your eyes back towards the quarterback, you're in a position to make a play on the ball, whether it's a big-time play by you or an overthrow by the quarterback. You have a much better opportunity.
The 49ers offense making its way back out there. This offense thankful, I'm sure, to have the football back, but also, Charles, after a long drive of their own, they've got to be a little weary.
Yeah, I would agree with that. And what you have to do to combat it, try and get fresh legs in where you can, especially to skill positions. And then for the offensive line, instead of attacking, maybe slow the tempo down a little bit, let them catch their breath.
They'll run on first down. Mitchell, and he'll work this forward for about three at second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Second and seven. Garoppolo looks to throw. That's to the right side, complete to Kittle.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a first down.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
In order to play really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4, those three guys up front, the nose tackle and the guys they call the defensive ends, they're usually big, big people because they're going to have to eat up a lot of blockers because it's usually 5-on-3. And when they do their job well, guys who play on the inside, those inside linebackers, they will just roam and hit.
And he'll take this one inside the 10, down to the 8. Give him 3 on the run there. Now they're looking at a 3rd and about 5. Two minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. Third down, Mitchell. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. So Garoppolo off, coming on is the veteran Robbie Gould for the 49er field goal. This just a 24-yard attempt. And Gold is able to put it through, and the lead moves to 10-0. So that one on target, and it adds to this first half lead.
And maybe we're too early to worry too much about 1-score lead, 2-score lead, etc., but this is where you kind of start banking those points that come in helpful later on.
Now it's Gold after splitting the uprights to kick this one away. This taken in at the goal line. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. A time again to see what Ryan Tannehill and the Titans can do.
I think this crowd not really sure what to make of things. You know, their guys have not looked very good. Their leader here at the top, he hasn't looked that great either.
And most of the time you hear guys talk about how they don't let the crowd affect them or they block it off. Well, that's not really fully true, because a lot of the times you ride the wave of emotion with a crowd when it's positive for you. In this case, they've got to find a way to shake it off and at least get something done to maybe put the crowd back on their side.
Absolutely. Give these guys something to cheer about.
Looking downfield for Jones. And it'll be incomplete. Good job staying with him defensively. And it'll bring up second down.
I know he wants to get his team back in the game, but a 50-50 ball right there that maybe was a little questionable.
Yeah, he's pretty lucky to get that one back. I think that sometimes these quarterbacks play with a lot of confidence that borders on arrogance, and that can put your team in some dutch.
Yeah, especially maybe want to look at some safer routes after the interception he had that ended their last drive.
And this throw incomplete. Now the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down.
And he's only hit on two of his first six passes. Time for a quick quarterback regroup here with a big third down coming up.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10.
And to give this time to the tailback. And he's going to be stopped well short of what he needed as the tackle is made at the 18-yard line.
Here's Brett Kern now, standing right on his own 5-yard line. His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. A 41-yard punt there with no return. And the Niners will go on offense, first and 10. There again is the running back as he trots onto the field. We're in the second quarter. They've got the lead. The lead, though, not so much because of the ground game, because of their air attack, Charles.
So what they're seeing so far is the possibility of things loosening up later in the ground game. Through the air first, maybe they have to start respecting that even more as the game goes on, and then there will be running lanes to find later.
Yeah, try to get him more involved here on this drive, maybe. On first down, Garoppolo. The tight end Kittle has it on the left side. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. From the 44, Garoppolo, and an incomplete pass. That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number one.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three. A shotgun snap for Garoppolo. Open man is Ayuk, complete. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. Again, they'll throw with Garoppolo. He'll fire this deep for Ayuk. And this is caught inside the five. Touchdown, 49ers.
Well, you're not going to hear Jimmy Garoppolo mentioned among the strongest arms in the league, but that doesn't mean he can't beat you with the long one.
And as that ball was hanging in the air with the receiver streaking downfield to meet it, here in the stadium, you could just sense the crowd thinking, oh, no. And their worst fears were realized as that one turned into a long touchdown.
And you get a look at the final readout on air distance, according to Next Gen Stats.
Gold to add the extra point. He's got it, and it's 17-0. So that drive, 4 plays. And the end result for the 49ers, a touchdown.
After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away.
And Hilliard will elect to not return it.
Getting set to go again on offense, we get a peek at Julio Jones now. They've got to be thinking, how can we get him a little bit more involved here? Second quarter, you're down, and really, he's been out of the mix.
I would agree with that, and oftentimes you hear, well, we're just taking what the defense is giving us. But sometimes that's just not good enough. Sometimes you have to take what you want, and that means getting him the football.
Yeah, so far just a single catch in this game. Now a first down throw, Tannehill.
Gets this to Ferkser, the tight end.
Now Tennessee going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Here's a second and two now from the 33. From the gun, here's Tannehill. Caught by Jones. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
Now the Titans will use their third and final timeout, as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. A shotgun snap for Tannehill. Got a man and he hits him in stride. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everybody, to our abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. First up, though, a look at the next-gen stats for the Niners in that first half. And there were a few factors as to why they built this good-size advantage, but the rushing numbers were not all that amazing. We'll see if they can pick it up in the second half. And meanwhile, for the Titans, there's a look at what they were able to do throwing the football. And they'll need to get things in gear as they trail here at the break.
All right, Coach, thank you. And we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. It's the 49ers out in front, and they will get the football first as well as we are back and started in the second half. And we will not see a return to start the half as this will be a touchback. The 49er offense set to go to begin quarter number three. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half, they didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities, and I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
Throwing on first is Garoppolo. Pressure comes, and the Titans able to bring him down. That sack by the DN, Danico Autry.
Well, that's tough, Charles. First play of the drive, you're hoping to stay ahead of schedule. You take that huge sack, and now you're facing second and a mile.
And the entire time, you were probably thinking the same thing I was. Either get rid of the ball, safely, of course, or go down. The yardage he gave up on that play, that's going to be tough for them to make up.
So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24. Garoppolo now. That's over the middle and caught by Ayuk. The reception good for seven. It's third down. Throwing now is Garoppolo. Completes it to the tight end, Kittle. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. They do get 10 back, but still a ways to go on fourth.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Wisnowski on to punt as he sends this one away.
So that one will be accepted.
Automatic first down.
So the special teams penalty cost some yardage there as they come out on first and 10. Now a handoff looking right. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and 4.
Well, I think after that run, the defense is getting back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them, and do I have enough confidence to make a play?
They run again with McNichols, and tackled down after a gain of 3, leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Back to throw, Tannehill. He's got a man. It's Firkser, the tight end. And he will have a Titans first down, and comfortably so, as he gets 5 there on third and a yard.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to 1.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. Fights through, and now a crease. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field.
Holding offense.
Hey, baby, this ain't good enough for us.
Now that's a good chunk of yardage. It's going to be canceled out.
And we always talk about hidden yardage in a game. That's going to count as that, because now it doesn't go on the books, but now they have to make that up again, don't they?
So following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a first and 20. Now they try the right side here. Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. It's a gain of 3, and it'll be second down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Throwing on second and long, Tannehill. He'll get this complete to Fitzpatrick. And he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35. That catch good for 5. It's third down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge, and that's good enough for a first down.
Well, we talk all the time about playing situational football, and right now I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they've got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try and get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That was a nice play there.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, first and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9.
We know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Now a handoff as they run left side. Only gets 3 yards there on the heels of the 1 yard pickup. Sets up 3rd and 6. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down. Here's a handoff out of the gun. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. That'll make it 4th down after a loss of 1.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
Here's Brett Kern now as he's on to punt for Tennessee. Averaging 50 yards a boot so far as this one's away. And no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds. The 49ers ready to set up shop again offensively. And now you've got the clock winding down here in the 3rd quarter. You're 3 scores to the good. What's your approach on this drive?
Too early to fully commit to playing the clock game. Yet at the same time, you're also not going pell-mell like you would in 2-minute offense. This is what NFL offenses call 4-minute football. Take the clock out of the game a little bit, wind it down, but at the same time, keep advancing the ball down the field.
On 1st down, it's Mitchell. He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of 6.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. You'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
Second and 4. To throw, it's Garoppolo. And that's incomplete. He was trying to get it to George Kittle, his tight end. But now it's 3rd down. Not his best throw there, but where we sit right now in the 3rd quarter, he's had a pretty good game throwing the football.
He certainly has, and it's not exactly at the point where we're doing 4-minute offense yet, but they've got to think about, I'm not going to say milking the clock, but understanding clock management here on out.
Now they face a 3rd down and 4 after that incompletion on 2nd down. To throw is Garoppolo. They'll run the screen with Mitchell. And he gets this up to the 34 out of bounds there.
Well, they certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another 1st down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Looking to throw, Garoppolo.
And the Titan defense steps up here, and down he goes.
Bud Dupree, give him the credit for the sack and a loss of 14 yards.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Nashville. It's 49er football here. They've got the lead as well as we get set to start the fourth and final quarter. So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24. Going to give this time to the tailback. And a short pickup here as he'll get up to about the 22-yard line.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
The Niners on third down. They've hit 4 of 7. This will be third and forever. They'll keep it on the ground. It's Mitchell. And he'll maybe get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down. So they went a little cautious there on third and long.
Yeah, nothing wrong with that. Remember, they're playing with a lead right now. So getting a first down, yes, that would be great. But even more importantly, take care of the football. No turnovers, no big plays for the other team, and keep the clock moving.
Here comes the 49ers punter now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. Forty-seven yards on the punt that time, just 1 yard on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Here's Tennessee ready to begin this drive offensively.
And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
Tannehill and the Titans come up now first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And that nearly intercepted. Oh, the free safety roaming into position, almost had it, but it's second down.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Here's Tannehill. Open man, Westbrook Akine. And they'll wind up getting this to the 37. Gain of 9.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
The Titans on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. Now Tannehill. Oh, he rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted.
Picked off by the former first-rounder, Jimmy Ward. And they'll set up shop right near midfield at the 49-yard line.
Well, offensively, Charles, hard to put a silver lining on this one. No secret that they had to take chances with a score where it is, and it leads to a turnover.
I love how you paint the picture, partner, because you're exactly right about that one. Look at the empty stares on that sideline. This is one of those games where you just want to go crawl under a rock until it's over.
They'll run on first down. Mitchell. And he's going to be stopped up at about the 47-yard line. Rashawn Evans out of Alabama had the tackle defensively.
Not a big run on the first play of the drive, but that doesn't necessarily mean it was a bad play. Sometimes you're just trying to settle in, get your guys a little bit of contact, and get things moving.
Right back to Mitchell on second down. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. Call it a gain of a couple, and that's going to leave him with a third and about five.
Here we go. 180! 55! 55!
There's Garoppolo to throw. And that is incomplete. Well, the other day they told us when we've got third and five or less, we have to be able to convert. And I guess every team would say that, Charles, but an opportunity miss there.
What they were trying to tell us is they believe it's a matchup game at that point. And they liked some matchups that they had, thought they could exploit them, unable to do so on that play.
And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. Now Garoppolo. He's going to look deep down the field. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. The Niners go for it, but it doesn't work out. And as a result, it'll be Titan football on the turnover on downs. So we were looking at each other up here in the booth when they went for that, saying, oh, wow, talk about trying to add insult to injury.
Some teams are just like that. You know, some philosophies, some coaches are like, look, when I got a chance to put some more points on the board, I don't care what the situation, I'm going to do it. And they're also the same coaches, as a general rule, that if someone does it to them, you won't hear people protest out of them. That's just who they are.
Tannehill and the Titans come up now first and 10 at the 45.
57, Mike, 57.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Flushed out right. And he works his way past the line of scrimmage and then slides to a halt. He'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down.
Now, how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
Looking to throw again on second down. Tannehill buying time to his left. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. He'll end up getting five out of that, but now they're looking at third down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
The offense on third down tonight, lacking much success, just 2 for 7 to this point. They're looking at third and a few inches. They take a shot downfield there, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Too many zeros on the stat sheet thus far. No touchdown passes, no points for his team, but he remains undaunted. Still attempting to get his team on the scoreboard, firing the ball downfield.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. They'll try and run for it. And I'm not sure he got there. Did they stop him? They did. He needed a yard. He didn't get anything. And the 49ers are going to get the football back. Though certainly not the way that they were hoping that possession would end, failing to convert on fourth.
And now they've got to make sure that they keep their poise, they keep their confidence. Just because it didn't work once doesn't mean if they get that same situation later that they shouldn't go for it again. The defense feels great, but the offense, they can't be despondent.
Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at their own 46. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's up over midfield and down into Tennessee territory. 64 yards rushing for him now to this point.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now,
I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine.
Right back to Mitchell on second down.
And this time he's able to take it down to the 42.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook. Go play action. Toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
Here we go. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports.
So it's 49er football here as we get you reset. And no doubt what they're looking to do is just salt away the final couple of minutes and escape with a win. And he's taken down inside the 30.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
And they'll run on the inside handoff.
And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. Give him 3 on the run there. Now they're looking at a 3rd and about 5.
So the victory here for San Francisco, and they did it in shutout fashion. Impressive.
Would it be too bland of a statement to say they didn't have the greatest day offensively?
Did enough, but yeah, you're right.
Most games, it wouldn't have been enough. So they've got to go into the locker room and applaud their defensive mates and say, guys, you really carried us today. We'll try and get you back next time. But as for today, you guys were nails out there.